Ladies and gentlemen, take the roof off from New South Wales, give it up for Nicholas Dorey!
Hey, I'm Nick Dorey, and I'm 15, which means I think I am a fully functional adult. Because once you get to 15, according to all the 15-year-olds I know, you're an adult, no matter what anybody says. Now, my dad, he still treats me like a child. He does all these patronizing little things that I just can't stand. Like the other day, he got my fork off my plate and he brought it up to my mouth going, "Here comes the year reply, Nick." And to show him I was far too old for this, I put my hands up against my mouth and went, "Here are the Twin Towers, Dad." Yeah, Dad's divorced now. It's a good thing that Mum and Dad got divorced, because when they got divorced, it was a bit like having a wee after a really, 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 really long time holding it in. All this pressure and tension just flushed down the toilet alongside their wedding rings. It is a good thing that they got divorced, though, because it's great for me. I get two of everything, so Christmas comes twice, Easter comes twice, my birthday comes twice, immunizations come twice. Which means I get autism twice. I could always tell that my parents would get a divorce. It was very easily predictable, and they did. They got a divorce last year, and my prediction came true, which is why I think I should be a fortune teller. Of course, Mum and Dad want me to be a doctor or a lawyer or something like that, but I can already foresee that that will not work out. Another reason I should be a fortune teller is I'm tall and I'm stingy, which means I'd be known as the large medium who shortchanges. Thanks. My sisters think I'm too tall, actually. They're always telling me to slow down and wait for them to catch up. So to help me with this, they've started giving me beer and cigarettes to stunt my growth. Other than this, they're pretty good sisters. They told me the saying, "Behind every great man is a greater woman." But every time I turn around, there's never anyone there. Thanks. I love to disappoint my parents. I love to disappoint my parents for one reason, and that is because it's how I get revenge on them for naming me Nick Doring, which is one of the easiest names to make fun of. You take the first letter of my first name, the first letter of my last name, you switch them, and you have Dick Noring. Which is a name that tends to stick around in the playground. Other variations of my name include Prick Boring, Dick Boring, Nick Boring. A lot of them have boring in them for some reason. I'm not sure exactly why that is. If anybody has any ideas as to why, I'll leave a suggestion box in my blog if anyone's interested in reading that. I'm a tall, lanky white guy. Thanks. I'm a tall, lanky white guy, which means I can't sing, I can't dance, I can't keep rhythm, I can't do anything to do with music, it's just not in my skinny genes. In fact, I'm so white that when I die of a heart attack, and I will die of a heart attack because of all the beer and cigarettes my sisters give me, when I die of a heart attack, on my gravestone it'll read, "Nick Doring, so white, even his heart couldn't keep the beat." Thank you, I've been Dick Noring. Nick Doring.
Give it up for Nicholas Doring, ladies and gentlemen!